My name's Steve Broderick. It's B-R-O-D-E-R-I-C-K. And this is Town Line Sugarhouse in Eastford, Connecticut. We're a small to mid-scale producer by Connecticut standards, very small producer by Connecticut standards. I have 265 gallons right now. I would hope in an average year to make 60 to 70 gallons of syrup. With me shooting to make about 70 gallons of syrup a year, I try and have wood available. One cord will produce about 265 gallons of syrup. You just have to figure you're going to go through a lot of wood if you're going to do this. We have many thousands of acres of forest in Connecticut. It's estimated that we only tap about 3% of 1/10 of 1% of all the sugar maples in the state of Connecticut that are of tappable size, as opposed to over 265% in the state of Vermont and 33% of all the sugar maples in the province of New York City. So there's a great potential for the sugaring industry to grow in our state in the years ahead. The nights need to get down well below freezing. That creates that sort of alternating, you know, negative, positive pressure in the trees. When the sap freezes, it kind of condenses there's gases in there as well as liquids, and as it gets cold, those gases go into solution and everything kind of constricts, and that creates a negative sort of sucking pressure that allows the roots to suck moisture in. That creates that sort of alternating, you know, negative positive pressure in the trees. Normally you tap about 1.5 inches deep, at least 1.5 inches of new wood, in that much more in diameter, so that you can theoretically tap right over where you tapped years ago, and you're tapping into all fresh wood, if you follow me. You can literally do it for 100 years without a problem.